Hello and welcome, fans. We have our first installment of the Replay Cast with Ted Casts. Of course, you know, I'm Chicago Ted, bringing to you this game sent in courtesy of Mining Turtle. So a huge shout out to him. Thank you very much for trying us out. And DotaCasters is the site if you guys want your own replay casted. So without further ado, not much introduction left to go for. We're going to go ahead straight on into this game now. It looks like we have a ranked all pick. So this is going to be a little interesting, a different style for me to cast. So we'll go ahead and press play on this one. And we'll just do a couple of little things here. You know, free camera, you know, I'm the broadcaster, don't need that. Fog of War will change, give a bit of a thumbs up for this one, and we're all set with that. So let's get rid of this menu, and we're going to start out with a Winter Wavern pick. That's Mining Turtle, our main man, going for the Frosty Dragon. And, you know, you don't see this guy a lot, especially not in things like Captain's Mode, but again, this is ranked all pick. Anything can happen. Anything can and will happen, that is, so... With the Winter Wavern first pick up, we're going to start seeing a couple of actual supports just go through. I don't think first pick core generally frowned upon in these sort of scenarios, though. Again, it's kind of more of a less structured way to do it. So we'll go along those same lines. Spirit Breaker, not so much a typical support, but does tend to take that roaming either off lane or just pure on all over the map role. Earthshaker and Witch Doctor, two incredibly good supports coming out for the Dire, a very good support duo too. They are very good at counter-initiating and just being able to be there and stop any aggression from either the ganks finding a kill or otherwise. And you throw them in a safe lane with any sort of hard carry and they will make sure that hard carry gets unobstructed free farm. So we've got an Ancient Apparition coming out, very frosty team so far from the Radiant. And Ancient Apparition is also going to help a lot versus Witch Doctor, but the Dire, they're going to go and grab themselves the Crystal Maiden, which kind of screams that one of these three heroes, typically either the Earthshaker or the Witch Doctor, more so the Earthshaker, I guess, would be the meta, will be playing a core role. And, I mean, they're still really good heroes. You throw core form on one of these guys, and they will be a monster, but it tends to be more of a, well, once you get the blinker, once you get the axe, then that's it. That's where you peak. And I guess Earthshaker tends to be a little bit more of a common pickup because he's, while he has that peak with his items and his abilities, he's still able to start from there going up in his physical damage output. Like, a carry is a hero that has a steroid that can deal sustained physical damage in the late game and continue increasing that damage output. And that's why you see heroes like your Juggernauts, like your Lunas. They build their right click, they burst heroes down that way. Like, magical damage is great early, but it scales off very, very quickly. So the Radiant, they're going to go ahead and grab themselves a Tidehunter while Legion Commander comes out from the Dire. Still no real hard late game for the Dire, but Legion definitely helps. Earthshaker will do all right given some good farm. And I mean, as it stands right now, neither team actually has that really hard late game advantage, but the Radiant, I'd say they're a little bit more lacking in that department. Wavern scales incredibly well, AA scales Slark. Incredibly well, but they don't have that damage dealer just yet. Slark will get you there, but he needs a lot of protection, and that's going to rely a lot on the Spirit Breaker and the Tidehunter to be walls of meat up in front, dealing what they need to do with their spells and keeping the fight in control for them. So that's going to be very difficult, again, with that Witch Doctor, with that Earthshaker. Control is something that the Dire has a hell of a lot of. And they're going to go ahead and grab themselves a TA, so some pretty good physical damage coming out from that one, but as it stands, purely from the drafting standpoint, I would like to see... I do like Dire's just a little bit more because they have some more core potential, but I can't count out Radiance just yet because they've got a huge amount of not just wombo combo, but team fight control. They just need to use their spells coercively, and they'll win a fight, so... We'll go ahead and introduce our players for this game. It's going to be... Okay. I'll just call him Daddy. Daddy's going to be playing that Slark right now. It's going to be Mining Turtle on the Winter Wavern. Stratch will be playing the Ancient Apparition mid only on the Tidehunter. Probably not staying true to his name this game. And Admiral Mr. Slippy Fist, he'll be on the Spirit Breaker. Meanwhile, Zygma will be on the Witch Doctor with a We Are Floating on the Templar Assassin. Back, it's going to be Rice Cooker on the Legion Commander with Sir Cameron on the Crystal Maiden. And Game of Noobs will be playing that Earth Shaker. So, might see a little bit of a meetup in the bottom rune spot. Neither team really grouping up for anything just yet. You see, we're taking a look. I think both runes actually could go to the Dire here, but nope, Daddy's going to come in, zone out that Witch Doctor, and grab his own bounty. We are floating. We'll go ahead and get the top, and so starts the game. We got a decent spread of Observer Wards coming out so far. You know, both teams going a little bit more aggressive on the opposite sides of the river. This giving a little bit more insight into how the mid lane's going, but you can take a look and see that the vision it provides still doesn't get you quite there. So it's good for scouting out the Roche Pit and getting that rune, but in terms of being able to secure things like ganks, it's nothing like a high ground ward, which, I mean, are difficult in their own respect because they get dewarded very often. So Tidehunter, not going to have that much trouble here in the offlane. You see Sir Senior Cameron is coming up and harassing him a little bit, but this Crystal Maiden, 39 base damage, is doing absolutely nothing to the thick hide of the Tidehunter. And he's got the Anchor Smash too, so he gets close, drops that on, and that Crystal Maiden, well, hits for literally nothing. In the mid lane, it's going to be a mid Slark versus a Templar Assassin, and TA, well, easily wins this lane. Slark gets bullied very quickly pre-level 6, and even after level 6, he takes one or two auto attacks and then has to get back and regenerate, but can't sell that regeneration short. Keeps him at least within experience range, as Senior Cameron goes in with another Frostbite, but that's it. He's out of, his arsenal's empty, and Tidehunter just going to stare him down, but in the mid lane, it's going to be Daddy. He's in a little bit of trouble running away from those Psyblades, and they won't cut him down just yet, but it puts a huge damper in his confidence here, as this TA is 10-1 matched up against the 2-0 of Daddy. So Zygma getting a blocking Observer Award. That's both of them down. Radiant also going for that sort of blocking style, so neither pull camp really has that option. You can do one single pull or double pull here in the Dire's side, but that's about it. Once that camp is gone, it's gone for the next 8 or so minutes. Courier, oh no, they've got a haste rune. Another minute before they can upgrade that. That courier will go down, still gets the bottle out, but that's 2 minutes without any sort of bottle curing, without any sort of extra item coming out for We Are Floating. And a nice pickoff from Daddy that gives him a little bit of extra gold, will help him get his boots up, and doesn't really help him out in any other respects. Not that much that he can get an advantage from that. But in the bottom lane, Game of Noobs, he will stay alive. It looks like a pretty heavy dive behind the tier 1 tower. Mining Turtle going to go through the trees here. Mr. Slippy Fizz taking a little bit of damage from that tower, but a cold embrace will bring him right back up to healthy hitting. And I mean, that'll be it for the bottom lane. This dual lane, not exactly the most effective, especially when going up against a tri lane. But again, they have plenty of counter initiation. I don't foresee them dying, but they will get bullied quite often if they get too close to the wave. And we'll have to keep an eye down there anyway, because a lot of aggression could be erupting in that lane. In the mid lane, I think Daddy's just going to go ahead and play very carefully, very safe. Doesn't want to give this We Are Floating any more than the absolute CS dominance that he's already been giving. In the top lane, I'm not quite sure mid only will be successfully harassed out of this one. I mean, he's still level 3, so I guess that's a little bit of a victory for the Dire. But aside from that, I mean, he's finding all right farm. One last hit is better than most offlaners can boast. And Daddy, he's going to go in with the Leash. We Are Floating with a couple of Melstrikes, and that's one more auto attack is all it's going to take. Can't get close enough for it, but you can't count out that Melstrike at all, especially if you're a Slark. And I mean, with 3 armor, doing pretty well. Nothing crazy, though. Mining Turtle is going to go down here in the bottom lane, and I mean, You know what, for the sake of doing a replay cast, we can go ahead and watch exactly what happened here. I mean, it looks like they dove. A couple of tower hits come through. The creeps are there. Yeah, the tower just brings them down. So a hard dive underneath the bottom tier 1 tower, and they get punished pretty heavily for it. Game of Noobs drops pretty low, and that's probably the bait that brought them in. The Witch Doctor also, Zygma, in a very unhealthy state, but he's just fine. And that's the first kill on the board. A first blood, so to speak, but it goes to the tower, so it's split between multiple. We are floating. He's going to go straight behind the tier 1 mid, looking through the jungle, trying to see what he can find. And he's not going to find Daddy. He will be revealed by this Observer Ward as going back to base, but that's about it. Dire's Courier coming back to life will bring whatever items We Are Floating needs. And so far, the CS, the net worth is just going way in favor of the Dire here. I mean, they don't really have much to say to this bottom lane. Their farmer is a Spirit Breaker, and he's been keeping up with the Slark, who's been pretty much shut down in the mid lane by We Are Floating. So far, I mean, the early game, not really going the way of the Radiant, but can't count them out. It's still 5 minutes into the game. We're going to see a Frostbite in the mid only, and they get a duel. No, they only have level 5. They're just going to go ahead with an overwhelming odds and bring down the big fish. Couple of arrows to the back over to go through any hide. And Mining Turtle makes his way up, trying to find some sort of counter-initiation, maybe some vengeance, but that's about it. They're going to bring the Spirit Breaker in, still charging. And it will go connect on the Legion Commander. What do they have to follow it up? They've got a bit of a slow hit after the press the attack, so he does get slowed up, taking a lot of damage from this one. Can they get a bash? Can they get anything? They cannot. And now a Frostbite. Mr. Slippyfist is in a lot of trouble here. One more auto attack comes through, and it will connect. Meanwhile, Daddy will go through, shivs down the Legion Commander, but will pay with his own life. It's a 3-for-1 right now, and that is an absolute disaster for the Radiant as they lose, they lose two. Where did the Ancient Apparition die? Looks like he may have died in the bottom lane, courtesy of that Earthshaker. 1-0, yep. Quite possibly got that kill, but a nice 600 gold and change going the way to the Dire team. Radiant only walking away with about 100.
Radiant structures like this. Radiant's
senior
Cameron
going toe to toe with this tie, but they've got the Winter Waver, and Mining Turtle is waiting in the wings, but I'm not quite sure if they'll be able to do anything here. Tide still not level 6. Meanwhile, we have a very close on Rice Cooker, and they're just going to force him straight out. Overwhelming Odds comes through with a sizable nuke. Mining Turtle's actually in a little bit of trouble. Will hit himself with a Cold Embrace, but that just sets up a little bit more. They've got the press the attack, a little bit of extra attack speed, and now he's going to go ahead, fly over the trees, and get himself out of there. So
a moment of silence for the Dire's
another courier kill. This time, it's going to be the Dire again. What is this? Daddy will find another courier kill here. Now he goes for We Are Floating, but I'm not quite sure either one will be able to get the kill. They'll probably just back each other off. A Meld Strike, still only level 1 with that 50 bonus damage, but Refract is full on its charges, which means it's going to be hitting or giving a pretty sizable amount of bonus damage if that Meld does come out with the Refraction. It's going to hurt a lot. And Daddy, it looks like he knows this. He did get his level 6 in the meantime, so he's able to go ahead, take some harass, and then regenerate right back up. It still is not a really optimal lane, as again, he's only got 11 CS, and poor man's shield and just getting his power treads. Meanwhile, We Are Floating. He's got his bottle and 1700 gold. That courier is still down, though, so he can't bring anything out to him just yet, but I don't think he really cares. You see the raw damage output he's getting just from his spells alone, so that's going to be Daddy being very careful in that lane. We Are Floating is, for lack of a better word, floating away with this game so far.
Missing
double damage.
Now, double damage goes away of Daddy. We Are Floating only finds himself a bounty rune. And this could make or break the next fight here. If Daddy can find a kill with this DD, this could be absolutely huge, but he's got to not reveal it, or else I don't think We Are Floating will give him that opportunity, but walks over the psionic trap, and that's about it. Looks for the other rune, won't find it. Goes back up north. We are floating. He knows this. Pops up the refraction shield. Walks under tower. Now goes back in. But this is a DD again. Remember on the Slark, the Mel strike, or the Mel goes down. Now the strike turns and fights. But I don't think either one's going to get the kill. No, no Shadow Walk. He has enough, probably enough if he tread switches, but it's not going to happen. We are floating. Finds a kill on a very greedy Slark play. And with a Frostbite. This is very reminiscent of that comment, that comic that came out, the Crystal Maiden, giving the Winter Waver in a what for here, and gonna have to TP back to base. Not gonna get canceled. The Crystal Maiden not aware of this. A charge goes in though. Game of Noobs in a little bit of trouble, but this is the paralyzing cast we were talking about. Great counter initiation there. Game of Noobs. Even though the Frostbite connects, they cannot continue to engage on this one. So we're at a cool 1-6 right now. 52 last hits to this Templar Assassin. We are floating. Getting a lot of gold out of this lane. And doesn't even have to leave it right now. He's got boots. I would imagine some phase boots. No, just go straight for a blink here. So looking to snowball with that blink initiation to find one shot, maybe two shots on any support. He finds the Winter Wavern. I don't think the Winter Wavern's going to even have time to react to this. Get the cold embrace on himself. If he finds the ancient apparition, well, there's nothing he can react with. He's just straight up dead. This Breaker will go for the charge in. Zygma might be in a little bit of trouble. Meanwhile, Rice Cooker finds a kill in the top lane, and nothing happens down here on bottom, but looks like that was a duel being spent. Lion Turtle goes in to try to save him, but now he's in a little bit of trouble. Will pop himself with a cold embrace. They've got a little bit of damage waiting for him to come out, and Game of Noobs actually throws it on him with the Enchant Totem. It's not really going to matter, as they got the overwhelming odds. A charge comes through, though, and Spearbreaker looking for a very aggressive one, but he's going to go right through. He's actually might stun up the Templar Assassin. No, he's actually going to stop the charge. Will go into the Templar Assassin. Takes a lot of damage in the meantime. Needs to be careful. One Meld Strike plus a follow-up, and he is straight up dead. Daddy's big. He's going to go straight on in with that haste rune. It looked like he had, and the Shadow Dance popped. Now turn around for the meld. The damage is real. Ms. Admiral Mr. Slippy Fist goes in. Two bashes, one courtesy of the charge, but the meld strike will clean him up. And he still has a blink. A Fisher comes through. Daddy's just gonna get blown to bits. A double kill for Rear Floating. And 1-10 so far in this game. Dire, they're just looking really good. They're looking for a Frostbite, won't find it, throws down the Crystal Nova anyway. And with a Splinter Blast going through, the slow is real. They've got another duel if they want to. And Rice Cooker going for my favorite build, the Shadow Blade out. He's got that Claymore ready to go. Mid only, meanwhile, living up to his name finally. Trying to find what he can in this mid. He's got level 6, but still pretty far off from that Blink Dagger. They're not stacking Ancients either. They've got one. Okay, maybe I spoke too soon. They've got a triple stack on these Ancients, so he's looking for at least maybe level 8 so that he can go ahead and clear those Ancient stacks without too much trouble. Meanwhile, on the top lane, they've got a duel, another win. But Daddy, he's looking for more. He's looking for something. He pops himself into the Shadow Dance, but there's no support for him. And now he's in a little bit of trouble. A psionic trap, but only of the 1 second, which means it's not going to slow a whole lot. And Daddy will be able to get away off the back of that one. Invis Rune, meanwhile, spawning in the bottom or top rune spot with floating. We'll take that one. And that is not a good sign. As I said, if he finds nearly anyone, he can blow them up. I'm pretty sure they know that Ancient Stack is here. He can probably just go ahead and take it. I don't think Radiant has any vision whatsoever to do anything about it. They probably wouldn't even know what was happening. Well, okay, maybe not. Daddy walking through. Knows they have vision as his Shadow Dance will go down. Meanwhile, oh my god. That's going to be a kill on the Witch Doctor down here in the bottom lane. A kill on Spirit Breaker. Cold Embrace, but that doesn't help you through the Maledict. That's magical damage, so he gets taken out by the Witch Doctor, who finds himself a Bounty Rune, and even more just going the way of the Dire here is, well, it's pretty early morning for me, so my eyesight's probably not where it should be, but we'll keep an eye on some more of these kills here as they're popping up like daisies all over the map. And even though we're at only about one kill per minute, there's no real structured fight behind some of these pickoffs. They're just, you know, overstepping your bounds, doing something, getting a little over aggressive and paying for it with your life, I guess is the most simple way to put it. a charge of darkness, a charge of literal darkness with that immortal coming through towards the mid lane. The creep does reveal it though, or does it? Does it give enough time? Floating might be in a little bit of trouble. They've got the first nether strike. They've got a ravage as well, but he does get the refracted charges. Will go for the melt, and now you've got the crystal nova, the freezing field, doing a hell of a lot of damage. Gets a double kill. They still bring down the Templar assassin, but Cameron might get a triple here. Nope, not enough to chase the Spirit Breaker. And that was one hell of a freezing Radiant's field down in the mid lane. Game of Noobs, meanwhile, will bring down Mining Turtle. And that'll be with the help of Zygma. So a 3-for-1 should have been could have been a clean kill in the mid lane, but this is what happened. I mean, no sentries versus a Templar Assassin. You're really, or even Dust, you're really setting yourself up for some big disappointments. And even now with a Shadow Blade, things, they're going to have to really start focusing on getting some vision out. Any sort of true sight would help immensely in these games. So Wall, Sir, Senior Cameron dying somewhere. Oh, that was a snipe off coming courtesy of Stratch here. So finds himself a nice little kill, and in the bottom lane though, it looks like that's where the action's happening. Game of Noobs looking for anything. He's got a Fisher up in 4 seconds. Mind Turtle walking a little bit too far forward, could pay for this one. We have a Spirit Breaker charge in. He's looking for Zygma, can't quite find him. Now a Sonic Trap, it isolates Mr. Slippy Fist, and that is going to be the death of him. But here we go with the Cold Embrace, the Arctic Curse, and they'll bring down with the Freezing Fiat, sorry, the Death Ward. Zygma now with the Ice Blast, cannot heal himself back up. He could die. Yep, one more tick, he is dead. Meanwhile, Rice Cooker finding the Ancient Apparition in the meantime, but we are floating with that Blink Dagger. Mining Turtle's in a lot of trouble. He'll go down. It's a 4-for-2 across the map. And with that team fight recap, yeah, you can just see the immense amount of gold, the immense amount Radiant's of experience too, going the way of the Dire. And it wouldn't be a ranked all pick without a little bit of all chat here, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the salt. As it's 6-19, 15 minutes. Daddy will go in towards that mid lane.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Again, trying to
days.
Find what he can out of this one. What do we got in terms of dual wins for this Leech Commander? 3 dual wins, 10 damage per dual win at level 1. That's a pretty hefty amount. Meanwhile, these ancient stacks are starting to stack up, I guess. Play on words there. Are there any capacity to take this? I mean, 2150, actually, mid only is getting very close to that blink. If he dies here, it could be a disaster. He does have Ravage. He's got to pop it to get himself out, but that could have just set up for putting it on cooldown here as he gets nothing from it. Senior Cameron, and we are floating. Go ahead and bring the fish down. They're trying to go ahead and look for some vengeance. Slippy Fist looking for the Mether Strike, but he can't get it. And the Fisher, it actually isolates. We are floating, but who's really isolated here? We've got the Cold Embrace helping Daddy here. Mining Turtle, they've got the Splinter Blast, and they'll bring down. We are floating. Game of Noobs now in a lot of trouble. Senior Cameron, they've got the duel, and Stratch will go down. But maybe they can punish this one. 382 victories in total for that Arcana on the Legion Commander. Senior Cameron, in the meantime, he's still hunting. Has a nice paralyzing cask bouncing between, I guess, not 2 stooges here, but they've got a Cold Embrace. Winter's Curse still on cooldown. 90 seconds. They popped it on that fight. Weren't able to do too much with it. And take a look at some of the net worth here. It's pretty scary for the Radiant team. It's Dire, the top 3. Zygma now with a paralyzing cask. It hits this time the 3 stooges. They're trying to cancel up the freezing field. They get it. Just barely in time to keep them all alive, and Zygma doesn't have much to say about this one. A Cold Embrace will bring Mining Turtle back up to a pretty sizable amount of HP, but 5 seconds, can they find the distance? This is where Blink Dagger sometimes is a little bit better, but I think for the cost, Shadow Blade is Radiant's always the better pickup. As mid only, he's got, speaking of Blink Daggers, he's got one of his own. And he'll go ahead for this Ancient Stack, but the problem is they've got an Observer Ward. They know what's going on, and we are floating. He's just going to go straight in, but pops the wrong Psionic Trap. He presses the R-Pop, and that goes. That could actually mean the kill for him. We are floating in a little bit of trouble now. They've got the Charge of Darkness in. Do they have any detection? They don't. Not yet, at least. There's four heroes surrounding, but he's got a Blink Dagger now. Cold Embrace Sigma is going to go in, but the Agents are doing a number to him. He'll go down to the Ice Blast. There's going to be a duel in, and Mr. Fister, whatever, he can't go bring him down here. It's going to be a 2-for-3 so far. We are floating, now going into Stratch. Stratch in a lot of trouble. That's a Desolator, but they're going to go ahead, pop out. They turn onto Daddy, and they're not going to get the kill for it. Sonic Trap goes down. He's got an invisibility, but he's not going to pop it. Knows that they have a Fissure for the AoE damage, but Game of News will get the kill regardless. That is a 4-for-1. They let Stratch get away, but they bring down the Slark, and that, wow. Oh, wait, no, did Slash end up getting away? Senior Cameron, he's going on the hunt, but the Ice Blast does scout out the Crystal Maiden. And he'll go into the trees. Crystal Maiden not in Radiant's any position to go through a tier 2 tower up to find a kill. Ice Blast, one more tick is... Oh, no, it needed two. It just needed two.
Radiant's Strength Treads
plus the... in trouble. Well, Blade Mail, not really, I guess, doing too much here. Armor, okay, whatever. But still very close there. And I guess only a level 1 Ice Blast is, what is it, a 9%? Not a... Oh, it's 10%, so if it had been one more level, he would have gotten the kill. But still, only a level 9 Ancient Apparition, 19 and a half minutes in. Sometimes Ancient Apparitions would go for something like the Hand of Midas to try to get them to that level 11 as quick as possible, and then use that residual gold to bring you to that Aghanim Scepter, but he's going straight in for the Ags. While it doesn't give him that level 11, it just means that Ags will be out slightly faster, and that should help their team fight a little bit. Mid only will go in though, finds himself a haste rune. That's exactly what they needed, but he doesn't scout out the Roche. That's a free Aegis going the way of Rear Floating. And they, oh no, this is going to be very difficult for them to deal with.
Guess what's happening? Invis
out from Rice Cooker, looking for that duel. Finds it on the Mining Turtle. Will it be enough? You've got the Arctic Bird. It's not going to do anything here. Rice Cooker will find another duel win. That's a level 2 duel now, so he's got 72 damage. Now Mr. Slippy Fist, he's in a little bit of trouble. There, Frostbite comes out, locked in place, but here's the Ravage. We are floating, first life is down. Shadow Dance to evade the paralyzing cast, but here's the Freezing Field. Daddy's got to leap out. They've got to blink though, or they've got stuff to catch up to him. The Psionic Trap to slow him down. He's going to go ahead and go into that, the Shadow Amulet, whatever they call the Fade here.
That's four.
They'll stun him up with the Fissure, but that doesn't cancel the invisibility. They've got a little bit of AoE, but they're not going to just raw spend it out. And actually, he misses with the Overwhelming Odds. You can't kill him. When he's in Invis, if you don't have Detection, he just regens it all back up. Ice Blast comes through. It's onto two. Daddy's in a little bit of trouble, though. Paralyzing Cast. They've got the Fissure as well. He doesn't have a Shadow Dance. They're going to pop the Echo onto him just to bring him down. And 11-31 of Charge comes through. They want Rice Cooker. Can they bring him down? No, the Frostbite, but the Cold, the Winter's Curse locks them all in place. And but a Paralyzing Cast hits between the three. The winners are the Cold Embrace, keeping Mining Turtle up, but Stratch not so lucky with that Desolator. They'll bring him down. Mining Turtle, he doesn't have Arctic Burn. He can't go over the wall. The blink forward, they'll bring him down, and that is a 4-for-1. They still get the Legion Commander, but that is all they can say about it. The tier 2 mid will go down, and they might even be able to break high ground here. But instead, they'll TP top, defend their own tier 1 tower, and
can't do nothing about dire structures right now.
Maybe a little bit too casual on this one. They should have pushed a little bit more on that, but especially considering things like the Ravage was down for another minute.
Dire's top tower's gone.
And perhaps I should save the humility of some of these. Oh, you can't mute Arkshot. Okay, so I can't save some embarrassment for someone who might call an early GG or something like that. So we'll just go ahead and take it as a fun factor of the game. But still, this tier 3 mid will stay standing. Unfortunately for the Dire, they definitely could have gone a little bit more aggressive on that one, and missing out on a pretty good opportunity there. Ice Blast will come bottom, hit on the Sigma, but it's not gonna really kill him. It's still no Aghanim Scepter out on our Snow Cone here, Stratch. Getting very close, so about 800 gold shy of it. which means he can go to a different lane and try to farm up, but they're waiting. Senior Cameron is up on the high ground. They've got We Are Floating too, and they just turn and meld him straight on down. Mid only, gonna go for the Ravage, but it's second too late. The Winner's Curse though, it'll bring down Gameron. No, it won't. It's a little bit too little time, and Cameron still survives. Mid only will go down. The Courier walks straight on by. Mountain Turtle gonna have to Arctic Burn himself up. They've got a dual blink on these two, but they cannot chase him up. They didn't guess correctly on his point of movement. And Mining Turtle will get away from this one. Stratch, though, he's got to be careful. Remember, they both have blinks. They go into him. He's very much dead. Hold on. They've got a charge. Senior Cameron, he is in a lot of trouble. They'll hit him with another strike, but that'll be just about it. We Are Floating is just ripping through these guys. Yule Scepter to slow him up. He can't blink after that. And, well, I mean, that'll be a 3-for-1, all for a Crystal Maiden. 13-37. I don't even want to look at the grabs right now, but I will. 20,000 already. You've got a 1,000 GPM advantage, or our XPM advantage for the Dire. GPM still within 15. Our gold is still within 15,000, but I say still within 15,000 as if it's not big. That is huge for 25 minutes. So a very long road ahead of the Radiant, but they can take solace in the fact that the Dire isn't exactly working those objectives like they could be right now. I mean, it's still a tier 2 top, still a tier 2 bottom. They're getting plenty of kills, but that's about it.
Radiant's top tower is taking hits.
Daddy will get away from a huge amount of damage. A Fissure comes through, but doesn't quite set up anything. And it's going to be pretty quiet across the map. Senior Cameron's on the roof, denying the bottom tier 1 or tier 2. Daddy, he's looking for something. The Ice Blast comes through. We Are Floating, gets hit by this. This is the green light. The tower will drop. The leash misses, but they get the charge in. They have another strike, and they just bring him down here. This is a BKB being popped. That's actually, he pops his BKB. That's not exactly worth it, or it is. They get the kill, but a 1,600 gold. Spirit Breaker gets a huge amount from that one kill. And hell, he could buy a hand of Midas right now if he wanted to. I almost want to say go for it. He's gonna go straight BKB. Okay, that's a little smart.
Radiant's bottom tower seen better days.
And I mean, losing your Slark there, not great. He's still very poor. Doesn't have his Shadow Blade out just yet, but at this point, you've got other core. You've got things you need to worry about that go beyond having a underfarmed Slark, and I guess getting a little bit of gold on your Spirit Breaker is well worth it. But popping that BKB got him that kill, so made it a 1-for-1. But in terms of worth, it definitely was worth it, because what just happened is he prevented that Slark from getting that 1,600 gold, and that would have completed his Shadow Blade and then sent him well on his way towards his next item. So heads up play from the TA, loses a BKB charge, but still gives them some hope. Okay, they've got plenty of hope. In fact, it's still their game to lose, but where I'd say this goes wrong is exactly what's happening. Legion Commander buying an Aghanim Scepter. So they're going to go in. Fissure catches on 3. Not enough time to react to this one. Mining Turtle will get taken out almost immediately. Ice Blast flies through, but doesn't connect. Ag's completed, though, on the Stratch. He'll have it back up in 30 seconds. Duel comes through. Blade Mail. No duel just yet. Shadow Amulet with the fade, but he gets fissured through it. And I was saying something about this Aghanim Scepter. When you've got a team that's coming back, you can't afford to give up duels. And with that Aghanim Scepter, you catch yourself in a bad position. You don't lose duels without Sans Aghanim Scepter. Hold on. Daddy is in a little bit of trouble. He's going to go in with a Shadow Dance. Now a Shadow Amulet. They've got the Nether Strike, a BKB onto Admiral Mr. Slippy Fist. They're going to duel him up, though. Ravage comes through. He might win this duel. Actually, he very well could, but he won't. It looks like they'll bring down 2, though. 3 actually will go down. 3-for-3 so far. Senior Cameron is now on the high ground from that charge. Puts him straight up on top with a Paralyzing Kaz. Could actually kill Stratch. He's got to be very careful. He's pretty tanky right now. With that Aghanim Scepter, Cold Embrace will keep mid only alive, and they'll bring down Senior Cameron. Zygma misses the Maledict, and now he's in a little bit of trouble. The Arctic Burn slowing him down so damn much. Paralyzing Cask will bounce to the creeps. They've got the Yule Scepter up, and that'll be it. They've got the Anchor Smash. No, he walks away. There's a Splinter Shot, and now he'll go down. But what a chase. A 5-for-3 is what it ends up being. I almost don't want to look at this recap, but I will. 7,000, or just shy of a swing in gold, and 7,000 for experience. What? Oh, man. That's actually closer to 9,000 for experience, just shy of. That is a crazy swing. We could take a look at the graphs, but that's about 50% of the net worth and experience difference that just went away. Yeah, that's exactly 50% of the net worth and experience lead that the Dire had accumulated in one fight. And so now you've got a Legion Commander who's stuck building an Aghanim Scepter. You can't do anything with this. She needs an Assault Cuirass. She needs a BKB. She needs something. But she is a marooned with this item choice that she decided to go for. And I think to fix this, you just leave the Rod of Wizardry. You go for that BKB and maybe build a Yasha or something without Alacrity. Do not continue this Ags or you lose. You've got the Ice Blast in the bottom lane. And speaking of, he's in a lot of trouble. This is where a BKB would come in handy. He's going to tick down, won't tick all the way to death, but he ticks low enough that if he walks back in, he could be in a little bit of trouble. You've got a winner, it's a Cold Embrace, and this could be another duel win. They could bring him down right here, right now. The charge comes through, stuns all three of them. The duel ends up going down. Stratch will get end up falling as well with the Echo Slam, and three will get melted here. Maybe a little bit of a poor engagement for the Radiant, but they only lose three, one of which has buyback. So I guess, by and large, a decent duel coming out from Rice Cooker. They're going to try to push high ground here, but this is a Ravage up, a buyback on the AA, and the only, Mining Turtle really makes a huge impact in some of these fights, so 35 seconds before I think Dire feel the heat. But what's this? A blink in from Rice Cooker, looking for a little over-aggressive play here. Gets charged, not punished though. Pop up, there's back row protection up. We'll go down in a couple of seconds. The charge comes through though. 10 seconds before anyone comes back though. And Mr. Slippy Fist will just get taken out. Has buyback, but that is a duel that went the way of Rice Cooker. 1600 gold in his bank account. He still goes for it. He finishes the Ags. I can't say I agree with this. Ice Blast comes through. We'll hit onto all five, and there's a Ravage. Hits everyone. They're all taking in so much damage here. It looks like they've got the Death Ward, but it didn't channel for long enough. We are floating. Pops his BKB, but that is just about it. Everyone's dropping like fireflies. I don't even know. They're just all going to go down. What a Ravage. What an Ice Blast coming through, and there's the Wombo, the teamfight control we talked in the draft. And another huge swing, this time a little bit, nope, never mind, not a little bit shy. 10,000 experience going the way of the Radiant. Only about 6,000, nope, 7,000 gold in that swing. But that brings it, if not to equilibrium, very, very close. Yeah, you're going to start to see that jump up in just a second, but what a fight. And they're going to get Roshan off the back of this. It looks like they've got a double damage rune on Daddy's. I don't think he deals enough damage. I don't think any of them deal enough damage, but they don't care. They've tasted the blood in the water. That's all they need. Momentum is huge in a game like Dota, and they're going to bring everyone in. They're continuing to go for it. Of course, you know, Daddy can regen a little bit, but not as quick as he's putting it. This is a very awkward Rosh attempt. Everyone's TPing in for the Dire. They've got everyone back. They've got blinks. They've got all sorts of things. Oh no, it's a call. Freezing field. What the hell? No duels, but that was maybe a little bit over aggressive for the Radiant. Count your chickens before they hatch. And Legion will find the Aegis. Still gives up the dual damage if she loses. And with that Aghanim Scepter, I can imagine she's going to lose a lot. You've seen every single time she's gone for that kind of iffy duel, she's been bailed out by the fact that they just can't kill her in that duel duration. Well, now they've got an unending duel. So they just wail on her until she's dead. And one bad click, and she gives up a pretty sizable amount of damage. We can take a look. Has she given up any damage so far? Right now, it does not look like it, so... Everyone will be back up and ready for Radiant, and they want to go next, and 5 seconds on the Ravage. They've got to be really careful. They cannot let another Ravage Ice Blast hit. And, I mean, it will be a little bit harder because it looks like that got a duel by the Fountain. And they weren't able to punish it, but the Ice Blast will come through, and this will actually take him down. This will kill him. So with the cold of the Winter's Curse, so heading on the Wheel of Floating, takes a lot of damage, but the Aegis will get popped onto Rice Cooker. Now he turns, looks for more. Bet Daddy will go ahead into that Shadow Dance stretch, taking a lot of damage, but won't end up dropping. Rice Cooker looking for more, 9 seconds on that duel, but in comes Mr. Slippy Fist. Nether Strike immediately brings down the Crystal Maiden. Rice Cooker with a duel and 2 seconds, and this is what I'm talking about. He casts it on someone. He could be in a lot of trouble here. Endless duel, and this is it. Stats being stolen, but he'll eventually win it. Okay, ends up working out for him, but the Ice Blast comes through. We'll clean him up immediately, and We Are Floating is not long for this world. That damage tick will bring him down, and look at that recap. Another huge amount. The gold actually doesn't swing that much because of the 3 buybacks, which is funny, but the experience, a lot goes the way of the Radiant.
Dire's lost a top tower.
And they lose a tower in the process. They do not end up breaking anything of the base. They get a lot of damage on the melee barracks, but that's it. It's going to regen pretty quickly, too. And slowly but surely, the Radiant are coming right back into this game. I mean, it's a 10,000 gold, a 15,000, or 10,000 experience, 15,000 gold game right now, but... 35 minutes in, that starts to mean less and less, and the abilities mean more and more, and right now you've been seeing the Ravage, the Ice Blast have been meaning a whole lot in some of these fights. Tidehunter has got Refresher's Orb, which I think is something that is one of the biggest things in this game. 2 Ravages plus the Ice Blast. And soon to be, what is this going to be, an Octarine Core for a Stratch? You know, I kind of hope it is, because that's a pretty good amount of HP he'll be getting from that. But also, the low cooldown, I mean, it's 40 seconds. He goes Shiva, though. All right. More magical damage, I guess, is good. I kind of wanted to see an Octarine Core, but what you want is sometimes not synonymous with what's good, so...
I'll take that.
Rice Cooker, meanwhile, with that Agam Scepter, now he finally is building towards that BKB. That's the item we wanted that I think he needed before that Ags was completed. But better late than never is the call here. Ice Blast will come through and it will connect on him, but this isn't going to be a hell of a lot of damage that does. The low cooldown is more of the reason why he's throwing it out at this point. Spearbreaker, he's still got only that BKB, not much to his name. This is where I'm saying that maybe the Hand of Midas could have been the call there, but because he had that BKB in that first fight, they turned it. That's what happened. There's a, looks like a Silver Edge, a huge amount of damage. Sigma's in a little bit of trouble, but they've got the Death Ward. Unfortunately for him, Daddy's also got Shadow Dance, so avoids most of that damage, and Daddy will just run away from this one. We are floating, trying to chase, but cannot chase quick enough. A nice little pickoff going the way of Daddy in 50 seconds. This is not an attempt you want to do, trying to break the base without a Witch Doctor. Senior Camera, hit by the Ice Blast. This is one that he's got to be a bit more careful of, because he's going to take a lot of damage from this. In fact, this is taking him a lot. 600, no, it's not going to bring him down. But it's hitting him for a pretty sizable amount. If he can chain up one more Ice Blast, he's got a mech, so I guess maybe not, but... Ice Blast, 15 seconds, maybe so. We can get some good vision off on this one. They do have an Observer Ward. I think spotted them out briefly. But they won't end up throwing it. Throws it to the bottom lane just to push out the creep wave a little bit. And that's all she wrote there. 5 minutes before Roshan comes back, the melee barracks... Almost regen back up to full. The ranged, not a single scratch. Meanwhile, 4 towers still up, but the top lane's pretty pushed in terms of, you know, well, towers, and that might be their target. If they win a good fight, then run top lane and go, but top lane's one of the hardest lanes to push in, especially when you're behind. Even bottom lane. I mean, the longer the lane is, the harder it is. You got to push out something like mid because it takes almost no time at all to close that distance. Meanwhile, butterfly completed by the Templar Assassin. We are floating. Floats like a butterfly, stings like a bee. But they're just going to go ahead and hang back. 38 minutes into this game, 29 to 52. But kills mean nothing. Throne means everything here. And we take a look again at these grabs, and they'll start to fall back down south. The farming patterns of the Dire are a little bit more efficient. But experience, the big thing here, is pretty much leveled up around a 10,000 advantage in the Dire. And we can attribute that to the fact that more and more heroes are getting to that level 25 threshold that we can take a look. Well, not really. Okay, 23 and 20 respectively, but the lower the level, the easier it is to get levels to, and waves are pushing in for the Radiant so they can have some good experience going their way. 39 minutes in. Do we see just come? Are you scared? That's the call out from our Tidehunter here. Willing them to fight into
swiftly
this.
Swiftly to the temple's defense.
But it looks like it's going to play pretty passive right now. Both teams playing it very careful. Not looking to do anything just yet. Senior Cameron, though, might break that silence. Goes in for the Frostbite, but the Forest Staff gets Mining Turtle away. Speaking of items, Senior Cameron is getting very close to that BKB, and a full Freezing Field with BKB, that's something you don't want to see every day. They still have the Nether Strike to cancel it up. They still have the Winter's Curse to cancel it as well, so a BKB is not the end-all for the Radiant. But they've got to be very careful about their timing on those spells, because once both of them are used, that's almost a green light for the Crystal Maiden to floor it, pedal to the metal, and drop down the biggest Freezing Field of her life. So BKB will happen. A duel. This is what I'm talking about. The Aghanim Scepter is going to mean the death of him because he's got no bailout. He'll go down and Mining Turtle gets some damage. 18, but it's still a lot. Aghanim Scepter. What an item. They're going to continue. They're going for more. They've got the charge in, but the Fisher will stop it. Almost imagine that a BKB would have been smart there. He pops it a little bit late. Not Radiant's sure what his plan was there, because now BKB is on cooldown for the next fight. Looks like their engagement, though, has happened. We are floating. The Ice Blast will connect. Even though he's got BKB, it still puts him under that debuff. Cannot regen, but won't take any damage. Looking for a bash. We'll get it with the charge. Nether Strike comes out, but it gets canceled by the Fisher. Now a Freezing Field with that BKB. Mining Turtle doesn't turn around. Doesn't look for the Winter's Curse just yet. Now he needs to go for it, but cannot pop it up. The Ravage comes out. Ravage number one at the very least. Echo Slam. Ravage number two. Will pop it up. Will die in the process. Daddy stealing a lot of stats here. And will use that. Starting to hit harder and harder each time. He's got 14 stacks of Essence Shift stolen. Looking for more. Cannot find it. Now goes for the Leash. Stunned up by the Paralyzing Cast, but that's it. But the stacks, they just can't build up fast enough. Another Ice Blast comes through, though. And it won't bring down We Are Floating, but it will bring down Game of News. And a buyback from the Tidehunter. As now it looks like Dire try to push the base once again. Legion Commander respawning in due time. Mid only, he's hanging in close. 100 seconds for Ravage, 150 for a double. Meanwhile, Ancient Apparition getting a lot of gold. He's 10 and 6 and 17. Got 67 last hits to his name, but his net worth is third highest. Okay. What? Ancient Apparition has the highest net worth on his team. Screw the Slark, who's only got second highest. He's not a core anymore. This is the Ancient Apparition. This is the Ancient Apparition show right now. An Ultimate Orb, Aghanim Scepter, Shiva's Guard. What does he build with that ultimate orb? Does he go? Is he going to go Lincoln Sphere? Almost imagine it might be good here. We are floating in a little bit of trouble here. He's going to pop his BKB, but I'm not quite sure what that's going to get him. Mr. Slippy Fist, he's looking for a bash, but takes one too many right clicks to the face. Rice Cooker now goes in with that duel, but there's a Cold Embrace, or a Winner's Curse, rather. This could be it. A duel win goes the way of the tide, just barely, and We Are Floating will go down as well. A Death Ward, but it deals absolute nothing to this ancient apparition, who again has so much farm. He's nearly doubling the net worth of the lowest in the board, which is his own team, by the way, the Spirit Breaker. That's an engagement you don't want to have happen. It looks like a dieback comes out from the Templar Assassin with that one. Indeed it is. And another duel one going away, this time to the Tidehunter. No. What? Who won that duel? It looks... He didn't win. He still got 120 damage. I'm not entirely sure what happened. But it looks like the duel win didn't go... Oh, that's right. It's Ancient Apparition. There's a bug here. Whenever Ancient Apparition kills with the Ice Blast, the duel win doesn't go through. I'm not sure if they fixed that, but obviously not. Because that... He didn't get a win. He's going to be able to go ahead and Dark Pact this one off. Leaps himself away, and that's all she wrote. Charge looks like it was coming through, but ends up getting canceled. Daddy with the Silver Edge. Now looks for Game of Noobs. He gets greedy, but it's going to be well worth it. Another strike also. Senior Cameron to bash immediately. It is a BKB, but he's got to be careful. One bash, and that's going to be it. It doesn't even matter. That Freezing Fill is doing no damage, and Admiral Mr. Slippy Fist will grab the kill. There's going to be another Ice Blast coming through, and Zygma will catch the tail end of that one. Does it get hit by the blast? It doesn't matter because he's got BKB anyway. Now a Death Ward. This one's going to do a little bit more damage. Mind Turtle in a lot of trouble, but will hit himself with the Cold Embrace. And that will be all she wrote. Four down. Does he duel on this one? Daddy not taking that much damage from it. Another Cold Embrace is all they need to survive this one. Daddy's actually going to get damage. And he gets it. Aghanim Scepter. Again, I was talking about it. I was very close to harping on it. Structures looking fortified. Dire's mid tower won't last. Oh my god, but that Ags. Not doing what they wanted to do, giving more damage to Radiant than it has to the Dire team. On to that mid tower. And now they're going to push down mid. Four down, three without buyback. And We Are Floating. Still no buyback onto him. They could actually go. What is this? Ancient Apparition is going full ice cream cone. He's got an Eye of Scotty. Hope the Dire weren't partial to that mid. And he's taking little to no damage from any of this. Game of Noobs in a little bit of trouble. We'll pop out the Echo Slam, but it does nothing. Daddy, he's laying in with the Ice Bar, the Shadow Dance. And they say, okay, kills, we don't need them. We're just going to go ahead and bring down these racks. Senior Cameron goes in. BKB Freezing Field. What can they do to stop this? Do they have a Winner's Curse? They do. But he's not going to pop it. Not yet, at least. Could go for it now, but still holding on to it. No one's died on Radiant. And now an Ice Blast comes through. It'll hit onto all three. The Ravage, the double. They've got so much to bring everyone down. That is almost it. Three down, no buyback. What can they do? A buyback from Earthshaker, but he's already done his Echo Slam. A pseudo Echo coming out from from Rice Cooker, but that's nothing. And just like that, I don't know. They've got another duel, but he's not going to spend it. He does spend it, and this is it. This bash is on Mr. Slippy Fist. He'll actually win the duel here, courtesy of that Desolator. But I don't think he survives for very much longer, because look at the slow from the Scotty. We'll bring him down. No buyback. And they can continue pushing. They ping it out. They want the Ancient. They taste blood. And GG, well played, is the call from the Templar Assassin. But of course, this is ranked all pick. It's not so simple. You've got to wait until the bitter end. Watch your Ancient crumble to pieces. And Radiant, look at this. All the way back from a 15,000 net worth disadvantage, hitting 20,000 experience at one point. And now, for the first time in this game, they've brought it back in favor of themselves. And it's going to be in good timing, because that is the final death for the Dire before their tier fours start to drop. And we, Senior Cameron and Zygma, they need to try to do something here. They want to defend their base, and it looks like they will do so successfully. The Radiant, they're not going to make the same mistakes Dire did. They're not going to hang around too long. They know that there are other objectives that they can go for. A little bit of interference with my mic there, but no trouble here. We've got the tier 3 top getting taken down pretty quickly. We are floating, doing some decent damage, but only doing well to push out the creep wave. They'll push out the bottom lane. Looks like the Rack's not taking that much damage, not taking any damage, so they're in no trouble here. 48 minutes into this game. Tier 3 is not that healthy up top. Roche is back up. This is, I guess, the final straw for the Dire. They're looking so in the red right now. And I mean, it's not because their heroes don't carry well. It's, I mean, I gotta say that their itemization, I think, for not gonna sugarcoat it, is crap. Aghanim Scepter is just not a great item for Legion Commander. Senior Cameron, I like what he's doing. He's got the BKB, the Blink, the Ghost Scepter, but that's about it. And it's Crystal Maiden doesn't carry the game. The Ags, the BKB, most you can hope for on these supports. But the cores, I mean, a Butterfly is great, but they need more. They need something to survive. They need an Assault Cuirass or something on their team. They need more. They need a lot more. They've got an Aegis. That's a step in the right direction. But now they've got to win a fight and end the game here, because they let this one go on too long. This Stark, his itemization, even though he was very far behind, every item just means that much more for him. Tide, I mean, he's got the refresher. Now he's got, oh my god, he's got a Veil of Discord. Ice Blast and double Ravage will kill everyone now.
Dire just couldn't save that bottom tower.
Winter Wavern, he's got a refreshers of his own. Stratch, he's got a refreshers of it. No, he's going Lincoln Sphere. Okay. So he's got a Lincoln Sphere of his own. This, a lot of balls of fury on the Radiant team. One big thing, though, is that both Rice Cooker and We Are Floating are going to have their buybacks. Well, We Are Floating's got his buyback. Rice Cooker's got it, and 400 gold. Which, I mean, this creep wave plus the next. As we have a disconnect, like we're probably going to see a quick pause here, but knowing unranked all pick, we might be seeing a couple of BM unpauses. I don't know. But buybacks on these two will be very good. I think they've also got the cheese from that Roshan. No. Do they? Take a look here. I suppose not. Looks like that was not the not the Roshan, not the third Roshan. Certainly feels like it. We're at a 50-minute game here. You'd think it'd go down three times. And yep, just as I suspected, a couple of BM unpauses, but we'll get back into this game very shortly. In fact, you know what? I have the power. This is a replay cast. We're back into this one. We got another pause. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. Another unpause.
All right.
Do we have another pause?
On.
Maybe.
I'll take that.
Yep. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. Another unpause. Do we have another pause? It's almost as fun as casting the game itself. Looks like not. Looks like Radiant are just going to take advantage of this one. They're going dead on into this. They want We Are Floating. They've got the Winter's Curse on their head. They've got two of them if they wanted it. And it looks like they'll do it. He doesn't refresh just yet. They've got a couple of BKBs. They're waiting this one out. He's waiting. He's watching. But the Death Ward is doing so much work right now. But in comes Daddy. In comes Stratch. These guys are so damn tanky. Aegis will pop. Now they might pop the second with the Winter's Curse. He will not refresh. It almost feels like he doesn't know he has it. And a disconnect. It looks like it's going to be Crystal Maiden moving around that Earthshaker. So Game of Noobs kind of back into this game. Splinter Shock goes out. They look for another Winner's Curse. They'll find it. Game of Noobs gets hit. The Ravage number one. Ravage number two. What damage can they do? It looks like a lot. The Veil of Discord coming out a little bit late, but it looks like actually that was the second one. Daddy, he's going to go in. That Aghanim Scepter duel again, giving him some damage. And that... Well, actually, no, it's not giving him damage because Ice Blast. So, another disconnect. And this time, I think it's it. 52 minutes in this game. Musical chairs where the disconnects and reconnects. But they've brought it. They've mirrored it across the equilibrium. The advantages. Just looking so poor right now for the Dire. I don't think they come back from this. There is no way they come back from this. Our friend Mining Turtle and his company have brought this game to a close, 50-61. And the Ancient, well, the Ancient drops adequate amount of salt from Brown right now as, yes, his disconnect, not that great timing. But to be perfectly honest, I wasn't sure that this momentum from Green, from the Dot Radiant, would ever stop. So, right. Well played from them, but to the bitter end is how you must fight. And you can guarantee that you have a good shot of winning this game. So guys, Dire versus Radiant, no real team names. This has been Replay Cast number one, courtesy of DotaCasters.com. Check it out if you want your own replay casted. This one, courtesy of Mining Turtle. Thank you very much for your support there, man. I'm out for this one. Thank you all so much for watching, and we will catch you all next time.